Alrighty. Oh lord. What new pain in the ass trip is this gonna be? A very long one, apparently. Oh yeah, that is some pain in the ass trip, alright. Come on, come on, come on! Okay, 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 what the... You fucker. I hate this so much, I really do. It's like, is there even a point to this? And how is it that this kind of technology exists? Big pregunta right there. Not even the ancient Egyptians had this kind of shit. This better make it. Don't slam on my fucking fingers. We set sail that night, the ship filled with cargoes to sell in the markets at Barcelona. Quote, we're talking the 14th century, the Muslims were still there. In the south, unfortunately, getting beaten, but they were still there. That's when Spain had it good. At first, all was well. Then, to avoid a coming storm, we laid anchor in the Otranto Harbor, which ironically around this time, because Ezio, this is like the 1480s, around this time Sultan Mehmed Al-Fatih the Conqueror will be, will send an army to invade the Otranto, the heel of Italy. You know how Italy looks like a boot? The heel part will be invaded and effectively conquered by a Turkish army, but at this same time, Sultan Mehmed will unfortunately die around Friday prayer, and the army is eventually recalled back to the mainland, and that pretty much... But I'm surprised I don't even hear the heralds commenting that in any point, saying that the Turks have invaded the south of Italia, and you know... All of Italy, you know, despite it was, you know, divided into all these city-states, they almost united. But again, the Turkish army left before any immediate action could be taken. But that just goes to show you how vulnerable how vulnerable Italy was. I mean, if Sultan Mehmed had not died, but had in fact been actually leading the expedition, he might have subjugated half of Italy within just a few months and been at the gates of Rome. That would have been pretty. That would have made him very infamous after that. To be known as the conqueror of Constantinople and Rome, it's like, damn, who pulls that off in one lifetime? Anyway, cloaked in darkness, the pirates came. I didn't see them until they were already boarding my ship. I hid with my family in the hold, pulling out the codex. I ran the worn leather cover through my hands, then I broke the spine. The pages slid silently onto the floor. I scattered them into the chests, boxes, and containers I was carrying to the market. The men who found us were drunk. I could smell it in their breath. Pirates were drunk? Really? Are you... Okay, seriously? Have some fucking professionalism. Okay? Do not drink on the fucking job. Oh my god. When they asked for the codex, I knew who had sent them. Holding back my rage, I said that I had thrown it overboard. What the hell is he holding back his rage about? They're drunk and all they've done is ask about the codex. I don't see anything to be enraged about. They started to laugh. Two held me down, still grinning, while the rest cut off my wife's clothes. Jerks. Okay, now that is something to be enraged about. Now you can be enraged. She begged for mercy until her voice gave out. Once they were done, they threw her into the sea. They took my cargo and sunk my ship and left me adrift, clinging to a piece of railing. I made it to the beach with my son. My wife's body washed up on shore the next morning with the tide. Filthy pirates. Well, I hear something. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. No, you don't. It's my money. Oh, this should be even more interesting than ever. But it seems like we're approaching a gravesite, as those are technically coffins. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Etchoo! Oh my god, you cannot do shit right. This is why I like your ancestor better. His game is simple, and he doesn't have these kind of problems. Really. Who the hell even complicates their grave like that? Really. You fucker! I hate you! Finally! Jerk. I hate my ancestor right now. Alrighty, so after that pain in the ass trip, can we please resume to just writing and reading shit? I never saw the sea again. Okay, that clearly traumatized you. Making my way to Florence, I rented a small room, then visited the bank. I had memorized Polo's account number. With the vast sum I now had at my disposal, I went to what vast sum? What the hell did he just get? I went to Venice in disguise to find my father. I returned to Florence the next day. Both Polo and my father are already dead. From that moment forward, I collected treatises on architecture, studied the classics, and took vocal lessons. Ooh, Aesop's Fables or something? And he's gonna go to Carnegie Hall. I adopted the name Auditore, impersonating a noble at the Florentine court. Accepted as one of their own, I took on the trap. Wait. I adopted the name Auditore, impersonating a noble at the Florentine court. Accepted as one of their own. Okay. Wouldn't the real Auditore technically be complaining about this guy impersonating him? I mean, that's just, you know, I don't know. I mean, I guess that sounds like a stupid question, but really, it sounds like an intelligent one. I took the trappings of nobility and constructed this via for myself and my son. And then, I hunted them. I raised my son to fight to find the Codex and to kill Templars. Together we would regain the honor of my wife and avenge the death of my father. Two deaths that could never be repaid. To the Auditore that reads this, remember that you are not a nobleman. You are not one of the deceivers. You are one of the people. Avenge us! Okay, new stupid question. If we're not an Auditore, who the fuck are we? This reminds me of that episode of, Everyone Loves Raymond, when they find out their real names, last names aren't Barone, when they might have just stolen it off somebody. And Robert at the end is like, then who the hell are we? You know, it's like, that's my question now. Who the hell are we? I mean, is our last name still Ibn La'ahad, La'ahad or something? I mean, I don't know. Tell me. In fact, what the hell even is Altair's last name? Because Ibn just means son of, and Lahad means nobody, because, you know, he really didn't know his parents. So, just random question, what the hell is even our last name? I mean, I know it can't be Miles, because after a certain while, obviously, after generations from Ezio to Altair, from Altair to Ezio to, you know, Desmond, somebody, you know, obviously had a daughter, and that daughter married some guy, and then she changed her name due to this westernized, you know, culture and whatnot. And, you know, I'm just saying. About damn fucking time. It's better been worth my time. Pain in the ass. Dumb shit assassin ancestor, you. Okay, where's the fucking stone? Okay, there's no gravestone here. How interesting. You just wasted my life and I don't even get a seal for it. It was a family crypt? You could have told me it was family crypt. Why the hell are you telling me assassin's tomb? Oh my god. What a fucking deception. Here I am thinking I'm gonna get another seal. No, I just wasted my life for just some random fairy tale. Thank you. Thank you very much.